Chiefs Kingdom, it's playoff time. But we did have a game today to talk about real quick. The Chiefs did beat the Chargers 13-12 in a game that honestly didn't matter and was fun to watch because it didn't matter. Nothing mattered at all. And Blaine Gabbert, in his first start since 2018, in his first start with the Chiefs, led them to a game-winning drive with Harrison Butker with just 4 minutes to go. He finished 15 of 30 for 144 yards and one interception. But what's not shown, he had 48 rushing yards, and LaMichael Perine had 21 carries for 76 yards. I mean, these backups just played out of their mind in a scenario that you wanted them to see. This was a test. This was to see how can you trust these guys for depth options in the playoffs. How can you trust these guys for options next season? I mean, ultimately, this was an audition for guys like LaMichael Perine, for guys like Cam Jones, for Joshua Williams, for Jalen Watson. These were tests to say, we've got some decisions to make this offseason. Can you fill those roles? Or do we need to make sure to sign that guy back or go sign somebody else? I'm telling you, it's absolutely great to see what we saw here. I know the score wasn't great. I know that it wasn't exactly the most fun game to watch at times. But overall, here's the thing. It was a confidence boost because your backups went in and played their heart out and ended up beating the Chargers. And you could see the smiles on the starter's face. You could see the smile on Chris Jones's face when he got his sack. You could just see everything that was right there in front of him, and they were so, so happy. I absolutely loved it. Now, the playoffs. Who can the Chiefs play? What can happen? There's three options, technically. If the Dolphins win Sunday Night Football, the Chiefs will play the Pittsburgh Steelers. If the Bills win Sunday Night Football, the Chiefs will play the Dolphins. If the Dolphins and Bills were to tie, I believe the Chiefs would play the Bills in Arrowhead. So, with that, three teams, who would you like to see in the postseason in round one? Is there somebody in these three guys that you would want to play? Would you want to play Buffalo? Would you want to play Miami? Or would you want to play Pittsburgh? Let me know in the comment section below, because I think it's interesting to see Chiefs don't get that first round bye this year. So you got to play somebody. Who would you like? Type BUF for Buffalo. Type MIA for Miami. And type PIT for the Pittsburgh Steelers. I'm telling you, it's an absolute good time to see what the Chiefs are going on. So who would you like? BUF, MIA, or PIT? Let me know in the comment section. Now, the receiving stats here go as followed. McCole Hardman was the leading receiver, 6 receptions, 77 yards. Good to see him back in full form. It seems like he's ready for the playoffs. That's nice. You got linebacker Pete Ryan, 3 catches, 33 yards. And Justin Ross, 2 catches for 17 yards. Not bad. Not bad at all. I liked what I saw from a lot of these guys. And I think we talked about how LaMichael Perine could be a viable option pretty much all season. We talked about how they could potentially use him in a lot of slots and that he was better than Clyde Edwards-Helaire. Well, guess what? They had Clyde. They had LaMichael. LaMichael went, and he had more rushing yards than Clyde did in the past 2 weeks combined. I like what I saw from LaMichael, and I would love to see him more often. Obviously, now it's the playoffs. You don't know what you're going to do. You can kind of figure out what to go with there, but it was nice. Now, if we look at the receiving stats for the Chargers, it's interesting because you have Donald Parham Jr., the tight end, going for 5 receptions for 83 yards. Joshua Palmer, the usual, 6 receptions, 44 yards. And then Austin Eckler, 738. But the fact that you're not seeing like actual receivers, like Palmer's the only receiver that was on here that was an actual wide receiver because Parham was his tight end, so you had random guys covering him. Palmer, most of the time, either had Joshua Williams or Jalen Watson on him. So therefore, he was playing really well. He was getting cut down. 6 for 44 is not bad for the guy who was supposed to be the top receiver in this game. I'll take that. Eckler is just going to get his receptions and yards. That's just Eckler. And the fact that it was only 38, pretty good. The fun thing about this game, I mentioned the rushing attack from Blaine Gabbert. But how about Easton Stick? He also had some rushing ability. 13 carries, 77 yards. Didn't score a touchdown. But he had a 15-yard run in this game. I mean, Easton, credit to him, played pretty well. I got to be quite honest. Overall, knew what he was doing. And I think that he showed that he can be the backup to Justin Herbert on this team. That was pretty interesting. Now, Darius Davis was the interesting running back situation. 3 carries, 17 yards. And you could tell there was not a clear RB1. Like, Eckler couldn't get anything going. Joshua Kelly couldn't get anything going. So is Darius Davis. The funny thing about this is, you're questioning, Jace, he has a long of 18, but he only has 17 yards. Yeah, because the other two carries went for negative one. That's how good this Chiefs defensive line was. Malik Herring had two big points in the last drive where he sacked Mr. Easton Stick, and then he batted it past out. The defensive line of Chiefs had Chris Jones for part of it as he got that multi-million dollar sack, but otherwise, it was very good. I mean, this team played well and understood the situation of, we want to get some confidence out there? Well, we can do it right here. Now, if you want to get confidence in yourself and you want to start eating right on this New Year's, well, check out Factor Meals because you can get started on your resolutions with Factor so you're ready for the new year. Factor's ready-to-eat meal delivery takes the stress out of meal planning and sets you up for success in the new year. Skip the grocery stores, the prep work, and the cooking fatigue. Instead, get chef-crafted, dietitian-approved meals delivered right to your door. With over 35 meals to choose from per week, including options like keto, calorie smart, vegan, veggie, and more, plus over 55 weekly add-ons, you'll have a ton of nutritious and flavorful options to kickstart your resolution. Forget frantic lunch preps and rush dinners. Factor's two-minute meals are set with their secret weapon in the new year. You're going to fuel up fast with restaurant-quality meals, and they're all going to be delivered right to your door. Stress less over mealtimes in the new year. Factor's no prep, no mess meals, free up time otherwise spent shopping, cooking, and cleanup. No more wasting time in the kitchen. Head to factormeals.com/ChiefsChat50 and use code ChiefsChat50 to get 50% off. Once again, that's code ChiefsChat50 at factormeals.com/ChiefsChat50 to get 50% off. Go check it out. We're going to put that link in the comment section of this video and the description. Make sure you get that 50% off and try it out. I'm telling you, I did it for 1 week, and it's amazing. I got to keep getting more and more and more. I've been hooked ever since. The Chiefs offense versus the Chargers, without Patrick Mahomes, without Rasheed Rice, without Isaiah Pacheco, without Travis Kelce, still put up almost 300 yards at a 4.6 yards per play. Not bad. I like that you had 124 yards on the ground. You want to try and run that clock, kind of waste that time. And I liked it. There was the one interception. Going to happen. It's Blaine Gabbert. I mean, it's whatever. 28 carries, though, on the ground. 15 for 30 for Gabbert. Not bad. I mean, overall, this was a solid performance by this team, and they got the win. I mean, I think people are discrediting how much this win means because in some ways, the loss didn't mean much. I will say that. The loss didn't mean much. But a win, I think, gives you so much confidence going into the postseason, whoever you might play. Now, the Chargers' offense versus the Chiefs, that's where things got a little sketchy. They had over 350 yards with Easton Stick, which, like, you know, it's something that it stinks, but you have to remember, Le'Jarius Sneed not playing, Trent McDuffie not playing, your entire starting linebacking core not playing. That's fine. You did what you needed to do, and, like, you won the game. I think that's the ultimate thing. That return fumble by Mike Edwards, excuse me, was the biggest play of the game. And it was literally in the first drive. I mean, that's just amazing. I love to see it. And I can't wait to see this team in the playoffs because we're not going to see Blaine Gabbert, LaMichael Perine, and Mecole Hardman Jr. and the leadings. We're not going to see that. They're not going to be the star stat guys. But you know what we could see? We could see Patrick Mahomes go off. We could see this offense roll. We could see this team start to find their footing at the perfect time. And this win sets that up for success because you have that confidence. Even with the backups in, you still got the victory on the road against the division rival. Pretty good. So I ask you, how far will the Chiefs make the playoffs? Because we asked this question a week ago, and it was mixed opinions. It was losing the first round. It was go to the Super Bowl. I mean, there's everything in between there. So, how far will they make it? I want to know. Let me know in the comment section. Are they going to make it past the wild card round? Are they going to lose in the wild card round? Are they make it to the divisional? Are they going to make it to potentially the Super Bowl, AFC Championship? Well, get in the comment section and let me know because I certainly would appreciate that. And as you can see, we're getting subscribers on the daily right here at the Chiefs Report. And yeah, I want you to be one of them as well. We're putting out daily content even when my voice is so sore. And I thank you for listening to this entire video. I'm sorry you had to listen to this. I hope you enjoyed it and it was insightful in some ways and that you know what to expect and you're cheering on whichever team you want for Sunday Night Football. And we appreciate all of you. But hit that subscribe button. We're rooting for 50,000 sometime in the playoffs. I expect the Chiefs to be there for a little bit, and hopefully we're going to get some of that. So, man, I just can't thank y'all enough for an amazing season. And like I said at the start of this video, it's playoffs time. Records reset. Nothing matters. You go out, you play our hardest 1 week at a time, you win, you advance. That's all that matters. Without further ado, it's on to the playoffs.